Hey y'all, and welcome to Spare Room. I'm Karen Terry, and today we're going to talk about advertising your roleplay group. When running a roleplay group, there is one constant. It's a group, so you can't do it on your own. And what that means is at some point, you're going to need to recruit new members through advertising. Life happens, and sometimes people can't stay in the roleplay. No matter how good of an admin you are, you're going to have active players become inactive or leave altogether. So if you want your roleplay group to survive and thrive, you're going to need a regular dose of new members. Because of this, one of the duties of yourself and your moderator team is to advertise. Now, regardless of the specifics of the platform you're on, there are three elements to every roleplay advertisement: the written element, the visual element, and the call to action. Humans are visual creatures. Even though we're working in a largely text-based medium, the best way to get people's attention is still with their eyeballs. Think about books. No matter how good a book is, you still need an effective cover to sell that book. And your role play is no different. So that means either you or someone on your moderator team needs to be making graphics for your role play. But what if none of your moderator team has graphic skills? So you can find people in the role play community to make graphics for you, and this is a totally fine way to go. Just keep in mind that you can't make changes or updates yourself if you go this route. So I think it's a little bit better to learn a bit of graphic design skills yourself or have someone on your moderator team do that. So I'm gonna give you Karen's sort of graphic design tips in 10 minutes or less. So use these if you have no graphic design skills. So first, think about the mood of your role play. Is it a cute, mellow town role play? Is it maybe a horror role play where the players are going to encounter monsters and other violent things? Is it maybe a typical Dungeons and Dragons style fantasy where your character is going to be interacting with elements that are fantastic or alien? So think about that mood that you want to convey. Then think about movies that convey a similar mood. Now, go look up movie posters for a list of about 10 or so at least movies that convey that similar mood. So your graphic is supposed to get people to engage with your roleplay advertisement, just like a movie poster does for a movie. So when you're looking at these movie posters, what you're going to notice is different tropes that are shared across a genre. So think about these tropes, note them, and then copy them. So let's say movies aren't your thing. You could still do this with book covers or promotional material for television shows. It's the same idea. Essentially, what you're doing is looking at the material that has the same mood conveyed that you want for your role play and copying it. We're not making any money off of our role play, so it's perfectly fine to do this so long as we aren't copying things whole cloth and we're just taking inspiration from the tropes. And what you're gonna find is the more you keep copying, eventually you'll have actual graphic design skills and you can do this all on your own. Okay, so this is one element of the advertisement. The other element is the text element. And I would say that this text element needs to be your plot or your plot summary. Now, I made a whole video about how to write engaging RPG plots and plot summaries, so I'll link that up in the card. So make sure you have that written because that needs to go in your advertisement. Remember, your plot summary is like your back of the book, so that's why it's really critical to get that into your advertisement. Any other written information is going to depend largely on the platform. Some platforms are going to allow you to write a lot more than others, so the more space you have to write, the more you can put in there. If you have lots of space to write, consider putting in things that set your players' expectations for the roleplay. For example, is your roleplay considered para or multi-para? Do you write in first person or third person? Do you want to advertise that you have friendly staff and moderators? Maybe you want to say that your roleplay is LGBT friendly. Think about the things that are gonna attract the types of players you want to attract and put those in your ad. The third element is your call to action. If your roleplay has a lot of world building, consider putting in a link to where the players can read more about your world. If it's an application-based roleplay, maybe link to the application. Or link the players to the location where the roleplay is hosted. If it's a Twitter roleplay, link to the Twitter profile. If it's a Discord roleplay, include the join link for the Discord server. Whatever it is that you want your potential players to do after reading your ad, make sure that that is clear and linked in the advertisement. Now that we've got the basics of the advertisement down, let's talk a little bit about advertising on different platforms. So at minimum, you need to be advertising on the platform that your roleplay is hosted on. If it's a JSync roleplay, advertise on JSync. If it's a Tumblr roleplay, advertise on Tumblr. No matter where it is that your roleplay is hosted, you want to make sure that the people who like roleplaying on that platform see your roleplay. So at minimum, it should be advertised there. I would also recommend widening your advertising and do it on other platforms as well. Players are usually pretty okay with learning a new platform if they're really engaged by your plot and your setting. Keep in mind, however, that the more platforms that you advertise on, the more work has to be done by you and your moderation team, because every platform has little quirks and differences to what they expect to see in a roleplay advertisement. To effectively advertise on a platform, you'll need to follow the norms of that platform. So look at other accounts that are doing similar advertising and see kind of what is expected in a roleplay advertisement in that particular area, and make sure you're matching your advertisement to what people do on that platform. You're not going to catch the eye of potential players if you don't follow the norms of that platform, because they're not going to realize what they're looking at exactly and potentially not read your advertisement. So when in Rome, do as the Romans do and tailor those three elements to match what the norms are on that platform. So what platforms do you guys advertise on? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm really curious. I could potentially make videos about how to advertise on specific platforms, but I don't know how useful that would be because the norms kind of change and it varies a little bit depending on the type of role play. But if you guys would find that useful, like if you struggle to advertise on specific platforms, then I could potentially make some videos about that. So let me know. Now that we have the basics down, let's talk about some advertising tips and tricks. First of all, don't spam. No one's going to join your role play if they're annoyed by it. So pay attention when you're researching the different platforms, how often people advertise, and make sure you follow suit. You could also make things easier on yourself by doing cross-platform advertisement. So for example, in my role play, we advertise on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. But Instagram is the main kind of group of role players that we're targeting. So what we do is we post the advertisements on Instagram, and then we use an app called IFTTT to automatically cross-post everything we put on Instagram over to Facebook and Twitter, since we're not directly targeting those particular groups of role players, but we still want to get our message out to them just in case. Next tip, don't write too much. Your players should be able to assess quickly whether they want to know more about your role play from your advertisement. So think about an advertisement on TV. Those are usually like 30 seconds or 60 seconds. So you essentially want to engage somebody in that sort of 30 to 60 second time frame. If it takes several minutes to read through your advertisement, then you're potentially losing people just from the fact that it takes them so long to get through the ad. Think about when you're watching advertisements online, like on YouTube, and one that's like 10 minutes long pops up. How often do you actually sit through the 10-minute ad? Like, pretty much never, right? You pretty much always hit skip. You don't want anyone hitting skip on your advertisement. And the last tip is, don't stop. Advertising isn't something that you just do once and that's it. Build it and they will come is a lie. Advertising is something that you need to be doing throughout the run of the role play. If you don't, what's going to happen is that new players are going to stop coming, while at the same time, current players are going to start to become inactive or drop out of the role play, and then the role play will slowly die. Keep in mind, most people that join your role play saw your advertisement multiple times before they clicked that call to action. So that means the only time it's appropriate to stop advertising is if you stop wanting new players. What other tips do you guys have for advertising your roleplay? Do you have a particular strategy that maybe works really well for you? Let me know down below. And remember to like if you like this video, comment down below with any questions that you have, subscribe for more videos, click that bell for notifications, all the links to my social media down in the doobly-doo. Thank you so much for watching, and make it a great day.